to how to get the Master Sword in Legend of Zelda. I am wearing a girl outfit. And I don't know all about this game, but I'm just sharing a little thing. I think other people have made this video, but I'm gonna make it because why the heck not? So, let's do this. So, from you need to get to the Woodland Tower or not, whatever you want to do. And you need to get over there. You can't go into the mist because it will engulf you and make it so you can't get in. And this is a bunch of puzzles, so you need to brace yourself. And it's hard for me, so if I mess up, don't blame me. And before you do this, I learned the hard way, and then I looked it up. But that's besides the point. You need to have the 13 hearts to be able to pull. Okay, I do not want to deal with you right now. Thank you. You don't need any specific gear, just 13 hearts. And you will appear here, in the Lost Woods. What was that? Okay, well, then there's torches. And mist will engulf you. Is that music? I'm not in the mood for this. So, I never was able to listen to what's here. So, you have to follow the torches. And there will be a point where there's no torches. So then you have to go to, I think it's something, just first of all, keep following the torches and have light with you because you will find a torch. But, see, I'm gonna show you a demonstration if I get engulfed by it. The trees are very creepy. And eventually, you will get there to a double torch area. Wow, this is very creepy. So, I just like to use that. So, you will have to go, I think, over here. Let's see. You'll have to go around to this clearing. So, which will be from here. No, I'm not good at walkthroughs, so cut me some slack, guys. Over around here, I would say. You need to keep going, but if you see, like, thick mist, turn back. And there is a torch there. I just already... Yeah, see? It will try to engulf you, and if you do, walk away from it. Because... it will send you back to your checkpoint. You will start at the beginning, or if you've had those double torches, it will send you there. That acts as like a checkpoint. I'm not messing up, so. And when you see your buzzer, that means you're getting somewhere. So, and this clearing area is safe. So, and once you get there, you're gonna have to go to the top right from my perspective. I'll just show you guys. And a problem with other ones, they kinda just cut. You know, I'm not even gonna explain. Oh. Okay, this is creepy. I don't like the music. Well, you will be kind of safe here. And like I said, nothing is needed but 13 hearts and most likely a torch recommended. And then you'll get here, and I'm gonna give you guys a demonstration on what will happen if you don't have the right amount of torches. Also, you'll see the Great Deku Tree, and when you get here, there will be a cutscene. And some peaceful music will be playing. The Great Deku Tree is right there, and he will talk to you, say you have returned and stuff. And then, here. But golden hearts don't count, so you need to collect all of them. So, and then you can try to pull it, and then hold it, and when you get to one quarter of a heart, the Great Deku Tree will stop you. See, I only have around 8 hearts, and, oh, he doesn't stop you the second time, so I'm dead now. Well, that's mighty dandy, so... that's a demonstration on how to do it, and I'm just going to explore around there if I spawn back there. And if you don't know how to get them and you're new to Legend of Zelda, you just bought it to play it for fun. Oh, there's a shrine nearby. I might as well do that because I have extra time. So, ooh, what's that guy? Silent Princess. Also, you'll have glowy head. It's Mr. Hero. Aw. We'll take this one. I want to see a bloopy. I can't read. Aw. I'm not, I don't know what to do. Could it be? You're Mr. Hero. They call me Mr. Hero. I'm not even. So. And I didn't figure this out until later. It took me a while. And, okay, apparently there's another thing you can do. All the shrines in Korok Forest so that you can be considered a real grown-up. Okay. So if Koroks can do it, I can. Read that and you can do Trial 2. So, I'll do it. Maybe I'll have to make a part 2 to this. Trial 1. Selfless Forest. Wonderful prizes! And if there's shrines, I will do it. Is this a side quest? I hope. Nope. Well, I just couldn't have done that. So I think I have to go this way. Oh, it's so peaceful here. They think you had to go through a creepy forest. And I'm just going to show you where this is on the map. You would have to go from Central Hyrule and go like... just Central Hyrule, go forward, you'll see it, and you have to go around, I'm gonna mark it on my map here, around to here, and then go through here. And you can't just cut through, because then you're gonna get engulfed by mist. And if you do it yourself, you'll see what I mean. I wasn't able to demonstrate. I thought I would be able to, but it never happened. Am I gonna have to go back into the mist for this? Hopefully not. Yep. No, this is where all the Koroks are. Couldn't I just get like Korok seeds? I was gonna light it on fire, but this is. Oh, it's a Korok! Of course! And I lost my controller, so I'm just playing with my Joy-Cons. She will show you the way spying their iron to win. Trial of Second Sight. Okay, yes.
What do you mean?
What? I don't even know, Daryl. Daryl is talking nonsense to me. Creepy trees will show you the way. Cut down a tree for the fun of it. Oh, no. That is what will happen. No. Do I have to go another way? Oh, no. Yeah, then that will happen if you die. Well, pretty much that's the best demonstration I can give for now. In the next video, I'll be going through all of that. Wow. Shrine nearby. I actually want to go to the shrine. Wait, what's that house? Korok Forest. No, I'm not going back. Well, I hope you all like this video. And I will see you all later with probably another guide. Goodbye, there's saltwater taffy.